Mark, the best leaders at all levels in society create that space for themselves and drive the changes. We've seen here the health community step up. We've seen communities get together to help the elderly, to provide food, to take care of the sick. This COVID has shown that the real leaders are in all parts of society. And they're not held back by any system or the financial markets. They're driven by a stronger sense of purpose that is not expressed in just your own self-interest or in the monetary terms. We need to get out of this concept that self-worth is measured by net worth. It doesn't work. So the real leaders are people that understand that it's first and foremost to put themselves to the service of others. And by doing so, they're better off themselves as well. If you don't get to that point, you'll never be a great leader. And for some, it took me a little bit late to get there, but it is important that you get to that point. And then the world will open up a wealth of opportunities. It's not that easy. I understand that. There are some barriers. Wouldn't it be easy if all these barriers would have been taken away? But guess what? None of these issues would exist, because clearly then we would have solved them already. So these barriers are there to build up some resistance in us, to build up some determination, and to actually figure out a little bit mindfully how do we solve it. Like now, we find with the COVID crisis that we have enormous barriers. We've discovered that the nature, health, climate change, and economy are closely linked. We've discovered that our system leaves too many people behind. We have a social contract that is awful, especially with the people that we need most. We've also discovered, finally, that science counts. The countries that have taken the health science do better than the countries that are denying it, including the United States, where you could have avoided half the death or more, but out of sheer ignorance or making it a political issue, you end up with an absolutely freaking disaster. So we've learned about the importance of science that we have denied that climate change. And we've also learned about the need to work together globally, that we are first and foremost citizens of planet Earth. The COVID crisis doesn't know any boundaries. So these are enormous learnings that we now need to harness also as marketeers to build them into the plans of the future. And don't you want to work for a company that is positioned into categories, into needs of the future? One of the biggest issues we're going to have is job creation. Unemployment is going through the roof. Young people even more unemployed. The social cohesion issues that we did not address in the financial crisis, which we actually made worse, has resulted in populism and nationalism at the polls and the current crisis that we're now going through. Please, marketeers, let's not make the same mistake twice and go for the easy shuffle-ready projects to think that where we came from was better than where we are now. Let's design it right. And each and all of us have that responsibility in our own lives, in the companies that we represent, which is an amalgamation of the human beings that work there, and in the other things that we can influence. And it is very surprising to me if that wouldn't lead to a better plan than where we came from. This is a wonderful opportunity.
Yeah,
actually, to not just restart an economy, but to redesign it.